Hello, it's Adam again. Welcome back to The Secrets of Milton Creek.
George Smead, he was a bloke that came into Merston in the Victorian ages and set up basically a brickworks factory and brickfields throughout all of Merston. And over the years he brought more and more people into his employ and started building up Merston how it is today with those bricks. And he sold these bricks to different areas around the country, more notably to London for construction projects. And well, as his number of workers grew until he unfortunately passed away, and his company, Smead Dean Bricks, went on for a little while longer before they were bought out. At least a good portion of the company was bought out by Marshalls, I believe, and most of his brick fields no longer exist and has been built over by the Eurolink that was built in the area. And well, ladies and gentlemen, that's about all I know about Mr. Smead.
So now we're going to look into some of these books that we have here, and we're going to tell you the past glory Milton Creek. So what I'm on now is the Victorian dock where the barges used to come in to drop off the rubbish, and these things here would have connected to the front of the barge with this and would have been there to support the boat so it doesn't float away, because they were made out of wood, and if you look carefully the chains are still here today. So this is just one of the Victorian docks that are here, abandoned. So all along the edge of the barge dock where they used to break the ships and bring in goods and take bricks away to London, there's loads of metal nails. Now I wonder if they're all from the barges that used to be smashed here at Milton Creek. So just down here, look what we've seen. Now what is it, Chris?
The Smead Dean brick.
Yeah, so there's the S of Smead and then the D would have been there. I have a complete one at home, so I'll leave a photo of how they used to look. But that is just sitting outside.
Are you seeing the yellow ochre?
Yeah, that's just sitting outside Marshall's brick farm where Smead Dean used to build his bricks.
Yeah.
So that is special.
Special brick.
We're not going to take it though, because it's only half. Right, and apparently if we make our way up here is a landfill of the old bricks, so we're gonna go have a look. Let's see, is this a better example? No, they're all plain, so they wasn't used. So they were made after he died, George Smead. So, what I'm going to do is just pop along and see what else can be found. Look, there's loads of golf balls here. Oh my goodness, look at that. Lovely blue glass. Where's the sun? Look, black glass, Victorian again. Loads of stuff here, all under the bricks, hidden. Smead Dean. There we go.
I told you.
Now, isn't that lovely? We finally found the brick. It's a piece of metal there. I wonder if that was used during Smead Dean's life. I just wonder. Probably was. There we go. It's the first old bottle of the day, bottleneck. It's amber glass, yes. So that is Victorian, Edwardian. Oh my god! See that in the distance? It's a bottle dump. Oh my god. Oh my god. I just found a new bottle dump. And that is the landfill of George Smead. Oh wow, there's a Spitfire. Hope you can hear it. So everyone, this all here is the end of Marshall's, well, George Smead Brickfield. It's now Marshall's. Oh, look at that. There's a mini bottle dump down there.
Milton Creek is a shallow tidal inlet which runs from northeast from Sittingbourne to join the Swale at Elmley Reach. The area has a rich heritage dating from the Roman period and was an important industrial waterway for the Middle Ages. In the 19th century, the creek had become a hub for the paper and brick manufacturing trades. The paper industry made use of the creek supplying of water by sinking wells into the creek to increase the flow of the water. The wastewater returned to the creek is said it gave the area a bad smell. The brick and cement industries utilised natural raw material in the area, such as clay and chalk, to make the bricks. The creek also provides the means of transporting the finished goods using Thames sailing barges and tugboats. As rail and road networks in the early 20th century came into Sittingbourne, it meant barge use became less effective. Along with much of the industry along Milton Creek, they had all disappeared by the end of the Second World War in 1945. In the 1970s, slum clearance happened, making owners sell their industries. Today, Milton Creek is mostly silted up, and the new Swaleway Bridge means there is no longer any room for any such vessel. Now, just down the road from Milton Creek is a shop called Asda's. During the Second World War, a bomb hit where the ground is at Asda. During the war, the paper mill was the target to bomb. This was because of the rich heritage the area has. Further up on the creek is an old quarry. Lonely tires and wheelbarrows sit on the mud. Everything goes to road now, unfortunately. So here's a little fun fact. George Smeed's bricks actually built some of Buckingham Palace and the whole of London Tower Bridge. Milton Creek's only a little creek, but it's actually really big if you think about it. It was mixed together with the Kempsey Marsh and the West Swale. In medieval times, this was a wide waterway when the Swale was a great estuary and the towns off its banks provided good trade to the sea route from the Downs through the Soar to London. Everything was transported via barge and most things were sent to the Thames, where it then stacked up on other barges. Merston Brickfield in 1928, after George Smeed died, slowly went to an end, but it was still full of staples for the brickworks, and then it slowly came to an end, gradually, and then it was taken over by Marshalls, who is still there today. However, the area has shrunken down and most of it is now just abandoned.
Squeaky, get off the box. Go on, get off the box. Get off the box. I need to open the package. Get off the box. Oh, good girl. So everyone, I've just been sent this by the delivery man in FedEx. So let's open it. I think I know who it's from because it's art supplies and it says urgent delivery. So if this is what I think it is, I'm very grateful. So let's open it. What's going to be inside in the box? Let's see. Oh, this is exciting. Squeaky. Oh, this is going to be exciting. Let's have a look. Ooh. Right, let's take the stuffing out of the box. Oh, look at that. It is. Acrylic set. That is wonderful. 12 acrylic colours, 5 brushes, 1 palette, 1 paint knife. Well, that is fantastic. That's going to come in really, really handy in some of the craft projects I have in mind. Ooh, what is this? Oh, art paper. Oh, this is going to come in very handy. Oh, it's really, oh, that is lovely. It's the thick style art paper. Oh, yay. I think I know who it's from. Gary Jenkins. And I would just like to say a massive thank you, because let me open this. This is going to come in very, very handy in some of the crafts I'm planning to do. I may do some bottle stop printing with the acrylic paint on the paper. Or I may just paint a landscape, because Gary has been sending me emails and messages on social media and sending me all his lovely artwork. So I may be inspired by him and try to do some of my own. So massive thank you to Gary Jenkins. I'll leave his Facebook page in the description, because he shows off his artwork on Facebook. It's really, really good. Last week or the week after, I did add some photos of his artwork and lots of people liked it. So if you like art, then please head over to his Facebook page, Gary Jenkins Art and Stuff, I believe it's called. But I'll leave a link in the description. So massive thank you for this, Gary. I really, really appreciate it. Thank you.
So where we are now is a Victorian barge boat full of bricks, Smeadean bricks, marshed up on the land. It's still full of its bricks today. Me and Chris are now mudlarking here. Let's see what we can find, eh? Come on, let's go. So just down here is some pottery. That's a lovely colour. Maybe it's related to that boat, so I'm going to take it. And just down here is a early Victorian bottle. Well, maybe mid-Victorian, perhaps. I'm not very good at dating bottles, but I'll still take it anyway. That's a lovely find. And the aim of this video is to tell you a short video and information about the story of Milton Creek. If you would like a longer version, please comment below. Thank you. So everyone, I hope you've enjoyed this short little video. If you would like to see more history videos of my local area in Sittingbourne, then please do let me know, because I do have some videos which I could make. Some Roman, some Victorian, some medieval. There's loads of old structures, even a lost village local to me. So I could always make a few videos up during this winter or something. If this is something you'll like, then please leave me a comment below in the comment section. Thanks again, and I'll see you again very, very soon. Thank you. Bye-bye. As they disappear, reading out the names of all the places I have never been, looking out to sea, staring out to sea, dreaming of a wide world, dreaming of the wide world. Say